Peep peep llamas and alpacas, this is Livy, and welcome back to a speed art video. And actually, I just realized this is the actual first speed art of 2019. Like, of course, I did the coloring thing with Cuphead, but this is actually, I made this design. And I know a lot of you guys are thinking, what the f*** is that? I know, I've gotten that question quite a few times, and this picture, just the drawing part, not the full digitalized part yet, just the inking of it. I've been getting a lot of compliments on Twitter about that. It exploded so much on Twitter. It was unbelievable. I couldn't believe it. And what gave me the idea to draw something like this is, as you heard last week, I've been watching videos from this YouTuber named Lumpy Touch, who makes these pixelated animations that are very disturbing, but very awesome too, because I like stuff like that. It's really weird, but I do. And I like how he takes like innocent cartoon characters and makes them so disturbing. My favorite of his work are the Gorefield videos. I hope I'm saying that right. It's not Garfield, it's Gorefield, like gore. But yeah, basically I used Gorefield for the inspiration to make Creepy Cup. That's all I'm calling him. I know that's the most uncreative name, but Creepy Cup, that's the only name I can think about. It's way different than the possessed or evil cup in Cuphead itself. I always call it possessed cup, but the appropriate name is evil cup. That's the appropriate name for it. But I like to say possessed cup. It's just more fun to say, don't judge me. And I'm actually planning on doing a lot more with this character, as in Creepy Cup, this character. I'm actually planning on making a animated short. Like, it's not gonna be the greatest animation you'll ever see, but it's gonna be similar to what Lumpy Touch does, except it's not gonna be pixelated. It's not gonna be exactly like Lumpy Touch, because again, I don't wanna copy. That's not the right thing to do, but I wanna do something that's similar to that Gorefield animated short that he made. And I have a few ideas for what could happen. And it's, again, it's, I'm starting to think about it's too similar to the Gorefield. So one thing I could think about is it could be improvised. And I actually am thinking about asking another voice actor to voice act Creepy Cup. And I do some of the voices in it too. But yeah, I know someone that could do Creepy Cup very, very excellently. So fingers crossed, be hyped for that. I'm excited about this too. And like, I'm planning on even scripting it or just improvising it, which that's always fun too, to just improvise a script, like have an audio improvisation. I don't even know if I said that correctly or if that even is a word. But yeah, you're gonna be seeing some more with this character in the channel, because I'm very, very proud of how this turned out. Not just with the digital, but even when I inked it, you know, drawn it by hand and inked it, I was like, this turned out pretty cool. I know, I was like all dorking out of how cool that absolutely looked. And I have to tell you, this is quite a challenge to do digitally, especially with my node line pastel that I like to do, and which is what this animation is going to be. It's not going to be pixelated, because one thing, I don't know how to do that, and I don't want to, again, I don't want to copy Lumpy Touch. And I would like to do the node line pastels that I like to do. As I was saying, what the most difficult part is the tentacle things, the mutant things, virus, whatever you want to call it. I was trying to figure out how to make that. And what I was thinking about, I had some, you know, I made it flesh color, and I put some blue and red lines to make it look like they're veins. I think I could have done a little bit better, but I'm still very happy of how it turned out. Like, I don't want it to be too gory or anything. I made it look like one side of him looks almost absolutely normal, and the other side of him looks really messed up, which that's the plan, and kind of what Gorefield is like a little bit. But this, I had him like smiling, and one side of his face has no lips, broken teeth, and his tongue is always hanging out, and his eyelid is not there, and he has a crack in his cup, he has a broken straw, and the virus or tentacles is coming out of it. And what I like about it is that one of the things that really like gives me the creepy crawly heebie-jeebie type thing is mouths. I know this is going to sound dirty, but no, it's mouths in places that shouldn't be. Like right there, I drew a mouth on his stomach and on his hand, and there was a few in the tentacles, like, that have, like, teeth and a tongue and everything. I don't know. It's just, that always grossed me out. And when I hear about these true stories about people with tumors that actually have hair and teeth, that really grossed me out. And I try to, you know, make him look as virusy as possible. Those little lumps in the cracks that I made, and I actually tore off some of the skin off of his nose. I already mentioned Ed already, and I had his eye be absolutely bloodshot. And I just loved how that looked. And the other side, he's just happy and smiling and just absolutely normal, while the other side is like, what happened? And oh my god. The toughest part, I have to say, is the leg on the very bottom, because I was doing a wrapping effect, which I was like, okay, how am I gonna do that? But I'm really happy of how the result went, that it wrapped around the leg quite nicely, and the veins and the little spikes or bones or whatever you want to call them. I kind of think of it more as teeth. Like, that's another thing. Like, teeth, again, teeth in places that should not be there. That's another thing that really, like, grosses me out and everything. Like, I've heard it actually has happened. Like, people had extra teeth growing somewhere else. It's very rare, but it has happened. And oh my god. But, so I don't know what, he's not a zombie, but it looked like he is infected by some sort of virus or mutation. But I'm just really happy of how this turned out, and I cannot wait to make that little animation. Like I said, it's not going to be like some of the other animations on YouTube that are like so excellent and spectacular, but it's just something that's going to be a little bit different and fun and creepy. I just cannot wait to see how that turns out. But you tell me in the comment section below what you think about this drawing. I am so proud of this drawing. I'm proud of this idea, because I love Cuphead and I love creepy stuff and put it together. And I know there is a Cuphead creepypasta, and I would like to read it on the channel, but I don't know how to get in touch with the person who wrote it to get their permission to read it. So I'm sorry about that. But leave a like. It is very well appreciated. Hop aboard the alpaca bandwagon and subscribe and hit the bell for notification and to join that pee pee party. But this was Livy, and this happened Live Next, and I'll see you next time, my friends. See ya!